Hello everyone, Marga here. Today I'm going to make a card with this lovely life collection from Annette Green. And it's not a difficult card because I like the paper so much. I have a lot of paper also all used. The paper's name is Harmonious Hodgepodge. And you see I use a lot already. And I had a leftover piece from the paper, and this was the leftover piece. And I liked the rose so much, I really wanted to use it. But I don't want to put too much on top of it, so it stays this beautiful rose. But I had a 5x7 card, and then you see it's too small. But Annette has also, in our paper collection, these borders. You see, I cut one off from these borders. And I cut a little edge off here. And I cut the border already on the same length as the piece of paper, twice. So I think I'm going to match it. And I have a lot of other stuff. But that's coming when I'm further in my card making. So now, first of all, I must edge, I like to do it, the edges with the stress ink. And I used here the vintage photo. Oh, wrong button. I really, really, really love the new collection, I must say. And I had no time for a video on my samples, but to make from every sample a video, but now I have a little bit more time. Now, these borders also, pick them up, Marga. And the other one also. I go peek if my camera is rolling and I'm working in the middle, yes. I prepared a lot, so as I said, it's not a long video. First of all, I have here a piece of cardstock. This is old cardstock because this is from Basel. I have a few left here and it fits perfectly with the paper. So I'm going to glue this down first. Put some dots of the glue on the paper. You can also do this, but that makes a noise in a video. Now I hope I'm a little bit straight because I don't see it very well, but let's do it this higher, I think, yes. And now I'm first going to put these two on the bottom. And on the top, not only on the bottom, but one on the bottom and one on the top. See if they're also even a little bit more this way. Yes, and then I'm going to do this because then I can glue it better down. I had also a good choice for gluing it down on the piece of rose paper, but I think this is handier. I think. Maybe I'm totally wrong, but so, and now I must turn it because otherwise the rose is not. Let's see if I did it correct. Yes. Now I can do this on the top. Yes. I really, really, really love this. And then I have cut out. I must look for the die set. These two. From the same paper as the mat layer. Why does it stick this way? It's the 2139 borders and trims, and they have a lot of nice borders, and you can also use the, I don't throw this away, because you can use it also, and glue it down and do a different color in here, so don't throw it away. I think my husband is not thinking the same as I, but this is the border, yes, that is the one I'm going to do first, but I must cut it on the right height. Shall I cut it now, or I think I, yes, but I must have a small scissor. So this one, and glue it down also immediately because then I know which one is on which side. Higher here and makes such a nice difference. See? Only this little piece is looking great. Now this is too small for this this part, so all stuff I don't throw away. Now I do the same on this side. put it on the edge of the paper. I hope you can see it. Here is off the edge. Probably you don't see it, but I see it and then it's not okay. If I see it, then it must be different. I take a nip of my drink. So, I love it already. Now I have here, these two came out of the stamp set, and cutouts came from the 2 1 3 8 circles, banners and ribbons. These two. And then I stamped this one on this piece and happy birthday also on this piece. This is the, oh, I have no number on this one. I must look up the numbers on this one. I thought all had numbers, but, and now I doubt if I do this a little bit higher or I do this. Where's my tape? This is 1 millimeter high, so not so high. It looks immediately a little bit different. Now I think I'm going to do this one on here. I think, and I have here a wax stamp with wax with a bee on it. So I thought it's all so nice. It's in the corner, and I have here 2 bees, but they are not ready yet. I stamped them on, how do you call it? I have not paper here. It's not white. Paint on natural. Now I know the name. And I have here 2 Zig markers, Zig clean color markers, and 1 blender. So I try to give it a little bit color, but it's not acrylic, so I must do it a little bit. Once it's a little bit green. And look if it works. Wash it out. Yes, do it. You also on the top. And then here I want the yellow part. Then I wash it out also a little bit. I must say it's going easier than I thought. And then on the top, I do also a little bit of yellow in here. And then I mix it with the green. I show it to you a little bit closer. The other one the same. First the green. And do both now. Top and bottom. Then blend it a little bit. So. Then the yellow part. Normally I do also the wings, but There is totally no blue in it, in my paper, so I don't want also not a little bit of blue in it. So I don't do that now. What I maybe am going to do, but that I'm going to do at the last, is some glossy accent on the wings. Then they are so shiny. I'm going to look where I put them. Maybe I want a big one here. Small one on top. Because I want to see the rose as much as possible. I go look in the camera. Yes, I think this is the way to do. Oh, did I have here my double-sided adhesive? No. Oh, I cannot take it. I have the double-sided adhesive from a little corkzine, but it's on top of me. And I cannot open the cabinet because there is hanging my camera. And then you are going to be seasick. I'm going to do that. And it's not a difficult card. But I must say I like it. Maybe I'm going to splatter some white on it lately, but that's, I doubt a little bit. So I want this one in the corner. So. First I must glue this down. Somewhere here. I think it's not straight. Yes, now it is. And then I want to glue big B here. And I want to glue it only in the middle. Just a little bit on top of the, oh, stay here. So I can put the wings a little bit higher. This one is going on top. And then flying the other way. Now I'm doubting if I'm going to splatter some white splatters. Maybe it's nice. I think it's nice. I'm going to do that. Where is my... I have new ink. New splatter ink. Where did I leave it? Oh, yeah. Normally I need a box. But I try to splatter not so hard. I think I make a mess, but when I take the splatter box out, then everything, you don't see it anymore. So. This is very concentrated, I hear, so I need only a little bit. See, I take it. see there's not much in it, but this is an empty one. I go see if it's, maybe it's too much, so. I think this is not. I don't know if you see it, but there are small splatters. I think if I want bigger one, oh, here's a little bit of that ink on the top of this. That is the splatter I want, a little bit more thicker ones. I think I have everything around it also with splatters. No. This is enough. I'm going to do this in the must say I like it. It's not much what's in this, but this is from Spellbinder. Not much what's in there, but I think it's enough. And now I must clean my desk because I see here splatters and here splatters. Before I go further. In the meantime, my splatters can dry. Oh no. I'm glad you don't see my computer, because my computer is in front of me and the desktop is have a lot of colors, all splatters. Can you see the splatters? I think you can see them. Try it a little bit. And then I want to do the glossy accent on the wings of the bees. I only must be careful that I don't touch the white splatters. Start with the top one. Sometimes there come light bubbles in it, but go look. Yes. Now a big one. Light bubbles in it now. So I think it was okay in first time. Oh, and the light bubbles is also not a problem, because then you punch in it with a sharp tool. Now I'm going to try to show it to you closer, and now you see there is a, they are not shiny, they are, how do you say that, white, but if they dry they are really shiny. So I think I have a nice card, and for someone's birthday, and Thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time. Bye bye.